Only has 40 men in his compound. Evidently, he's become very lax in his waning years.
The fool.
I wouldn't count on information from traitors. The albino might have told them what to say if anyone asked questions.
She's right. The traitors may already have warned him that we are coming.
They will never warn anyone ever again. This time, we will reach the albino. And when we do, I will cut his heart out and eat it while he watches me with his dying breath. I did not know, of course.
About Curzon.
I did not want to risk contacting you by subspace.
I don't blame you. That's how the albino learned we were coming to Galdontair.
He has ears that reach across the galaxy. I don't know how. Tell me about my good friend Curzon. Did he die an honorable death?
He died in a hospital room, yelling at doctors and friends who were trying to keep him alive. For one more miserable day.
Oh, it's a pity. He was a good man. He deserved to die in battle. It pains me that I will never see him again in this life.
Curzon was decorated many times for his diplomatic achievements, but no honor touched him as deeply as yours. For a Klingon to choose a Federation official to be the godfather of his son.
Curzon Dax opened the door to peace. He was the first Federation diplomat I ever met who truly seemed to understand the Klingon nature.
Well, there was always a bit of Klingon nature in Curzon. His blood oath with you was very important to him.
Would you eat from the heart of the albino, Jadzia Dax? I know about the trills from my long friendship with Curzon. And I know that each new host has no obligation to pass commitments.
And I know that a Klingon blood oath can never be broken.
The old Klingon ways are passing. There was a time when I was a young man. The mere mention of a Klingon empire made worlds tremble. Now, our warriors are opening restaurants and serving wrath to the grandchildren of men I slaughtered in battle. Things are not what they used to be, not even the blood oath.
I know you, Kang. You don't believe that.
What I believe is no longer relevant. You are released from Curzon's oath. You owe nothing to any of us.
Are you still reading a plasma leak in Lower Pylon 1? I can't seem to find it now.
It's been intermittent. Let me do a high-resolution scan. Kira.
Uh-huh.
How many people did you kill?
What?
While you were in the underground.
Too many.
Were they all faceless Cardassians? Or did you know who you were killing?
Why are we talking about this?
If it bothers you, we can stop.
Yeah, it bothers me.
I'm sorry.
Why? Are you thinking about killing somebody? Me?
Tell me. I don't know what you're talking about.
Tell me.
Eighty years ago, there was a band of depredators. Led by an albino, raiding Klingon colonies. Three Klingon warships were sent to stop him. One of the captains was a close friend of Curzon's. The mission was successful. Most of them were captured. But the albino escaped. In his last message to the Klingons, he promised to take revenge on the firstborn of each of the three captains. A few years later, he kept his word.